And I have another camera outside. This one. It's my ZWO-224, and it's pointing to the sky and to the telescope. The clouds are trying to dissipate. We can see, you can barely see stars. So my plan is, I will start to answering. I received some questions about my setup, specifically the Equatorial platform I use. And I want to speak a bit about that. If you have any question, feel free to tell me in the chat. And if you are watching the replay, this will be about this topic. And then if the sky gives us the opportunity, we will point to an object. So the telescope I have outside is this one. The 8-inch Dobsonian GSO. It's over an equatorial platform here. See? And I received some doubts about people that bought a Dobsonian, like I have, without GoTo. The thing is, if you bought a Dobsonian, whether it's an 8-inch, a 6-inch, or 12, or 10, or other, but especially this kind of aperture, you probably bought it like I did. The first one was a 12-inch, and I use it a lot visually, which I still use and love it. But of course, passing the time, I wanted to see more. So I discovered EAA, and I wanted to do EAA, but I needed tracking. So if your Dobsonian is only for visual, and doesn't have a go-to, you can use it to watch the sky with an eyepiece, of course, with many eyepieces, and you can do the tracking. You can do astrophotography without tracking of the planets and the moon. It's very hard to go from the planets and the moon to little objects or some bright objects that some people do without tracking. It requires more ability, and sometimes it gets the people frustrated. So what is recommended, what I did was go to the path of the equatorial platform. The advantage is I only spend the money on the telescope. I used for many times doing the planetary imaging, and you can do it with the smartphone and also the visual. And then I bought the equatorial platform. Another advantage of the equatorial platform is you can use, as I do, with many telescopes. I used with a 12-inch I had before. And when I bought recently this 8-inch, I can have tracking with the same equatorial platform. And if I buy another telescope, another Dobsonian, I still can use one platform, many scopes. Even with that little refractor I have, even with a camera over the platform, because it tracks the sky. Now, if you are thinking, like the questions I received about going to the path I went of having a Dobsonian, then later buying the equatorial platform and have tracking to do EAA, it's perfect for that. You don't need anything else beside of the camera, of course. The first video I made with a review of the Equatorial platform from Geoptic is what I have. I said, and it's true, I bought before that platform another one that was made of wood and very fragile. What happened was that my 12-inch is too heavy for that kind of platform. However, what I think is, if you have an 8-inch, now that I have one, I can feel that, it may work with a lighter platform. But the 12-inch, no. And also, I can risk that 10-inch, it's not possible to work with a platform with that characteristics. So, my advice is, if you have until 8-inch, you have two options. You save for a cheaper platform, but knowing that in the future, if you upgrade your telescope, it will be useless. Or you can do as many people do, and very smart people, like Miguel, that was in the last live stream from Colombia. He did his own equatorial platform, and it works fine. So if you have that skill, you can do that. There are plans online that you can do, you can watch and replicate. The thing is, I can't do that. I have not that skill. I have not the tools to do that. To do that, I will have to go to someone that works the steel and the wood to make me all the parts to have the platform. And it was impossible for me to do that. Let me check only one thing, if it's working okay, the live stream. Okay, it is. Okay. My advice is, if you want to go to that path, the Equatorial platform, you will have the results I have, which are great results. You should save at least for a decent platform, which can be used with bigger telescopes, bigger Dobsonians, like the one I have from Geoptic. Or if you want to go from to a higher level, you can buy one which is more expensive from the European TEP or the American Tomahawk. Those are the two that I consider they have the best ones. They have three axes, not two like mine, which allows to do astrophotography using a guide scope and doing guiding. So that allows longer exposures, and that allows you to go to astrophotography. Now, if you want only what I want, which is do EAA, you can be fine with a medium range platform like this one. And it is made of steel, and it hangs well the weight of a big Dobsonian, like the 12-inch or even the 14-inch and so on. It goes until 80 kilograms. The TEP is it weighs more, so it's something to consider, but it will give you more precision with the three axes. So to use this platform or other that you have, it's very important also that you get the balance. I saw reviews of platforms, especially the TEP, which I thought it was unfair, because I saw a guy with the Dobsonian, and the Dobsonian almost failed. But I also saw that image show me that Dobsonian was not well placed in over the platform. It was not over the 3 points that the platform has. The TEP has also, and this one also has, 3 rubber plastic pads to center the platform in the right way. If you don't do that, if I place the Dobsonian out of the position it has to be, it will sure fall apart. So this is just to make a general idea for you that were in the last stream, and then I received some questions about this and what should you do, and that's my truly honest opinion about it. You just need something that track, even that is not too precise, something that track the sky, for you to have the ability to use SharpCap or other software. I use SharpCap to track the sky, and at the end, if you want, take a snapshot and have a nice picture of it. Of course, it's EAA. We want to observe. The pleasure is in observe the sky. And now I will go outside and I will check if the clouds are better. Let me see here. It's still cloudy, but I will check. Hold on. But it's like that. You see? See? Clouds everywhere. So this will be a video for the replay, basically about the meaning of the intention of having an equatorial platform in your setup, and the basic advantage of it. And thank you all to be here and to watch this video. And I'll see you tomorrow at 10 p.m. GMT. Okay, thank you. Bye bye.